So, 190 comments in 24 hours is pretty crazy. Obviously, the topic of me moving from Notion for personal use over to Evernote was quite a controversial topic and something that got people talking. So I wanted to address a few of those questions and comments in this video. It's gonna be short, sharp, so you can use the timestamps to actually cover this one. And I also do plan on doing a my full workflow video in the next week or two. To really explain how I'm using the tools in more detail. That's something that I want to make a bit more clear, just because I think the last one was more of a feeler video in terms of sharing why and how I'm using the tool. So the first comment actually came from Julia, and this is something I've definitely learned from this video, is actually stating, obviously, that I'm leaving it for personal use. I still am going to be using Notion for work use, so naturally, that's still active duty. However, I should have titled the video something a little bit different, so Julia is right in almost making a comedy out of that. Second thing is, I still will be covering Notion. Notion is a key productivity tool, and we're keen on covering it in the future, much like the other applications. For example, I don't use Obsidian, but we cover Obsidian here on the channel. So naturally, it's something that is important to continue to convey and share with you folks. So the third thing was actually a lot of people mentioning that they first heard about Notion from this YouTube channel, which is absolutely fantastic. I'm glad that you discovered something that is so prevalent in your life. I love that. It definitely has been a real factor in my life. I really enjoyed covering Notion in those early days because I was covering something so brand new. We'll continue to do this with not just Notion, but new tools that emerge their head in the productivity space. So there was a really good comment from Rob about whether this sort of, you know, the video actually conveyed the actual methods and tools I use and the whole productivity space in terms of talking about it. I 100% agree with what he's saying about the fact that in the productivity channels and space in general, it's not really necessarily, it's more mentioning tools, it's not necessarily going deep in how to use them. But definitely, I've found this as a huge thing that's been on my agenda the last 2 months. So I've definitely found the productivity space to be a bit more tool focused. So I want to keep productive to be that at the moment. But in the next couple of days, we'll be launching something that hopefully addresses that as a wider productivity conversation. I think it's a problem. And I want to address it, and hopefully we can as a collective. I loved August Bradley's comment of "we need to talk." That was really funny. Obviously, I can imagine a lot of people are going to go, "Francesco, I can set this up for you, or can convince you." But I think it's definitely a decision that moving forward is probably one that's best for me at the moment. Conversation about whether I should have chosen another app apart from Evernote. The only reason I'm going back to Evernote for personal use is because I've been using it for 7 or 8 years, and naturally it's the sort of go-to application because it's got everything I already need there. So I'm just limiting my apps and sort of focusing on one instead of migrating to a brand new one. So there was actually a Facebook comment about like me using 55 billion different apps or something like this. I've actually really only used 3 or 4 core apps over the last 10 years. I'm a real advocate of you pick one, you stick with one. We actually have a really good course. I don't think it's really good. We actually have a good course about how to pick the perfect to-do list application, both on Skillshare and on Thinkific. So I'll include them below. It's a free course. But I'm really keen on people staying with apps for more than 3 years. I think switching is dangerous. I think overindulgence is also can be a hampering of your productivity. So people curious how I'm using Evernote, very much the same as I did previously, but I will be doing a my productivity workflow video in the next week or so to address the apps I use and how I use them. Someone said delete other Notion videos. Probably not relevant, just because they're still very helpful for other people. My opinion is just something I share on the channel to help share lessons that I pick up on the way. So a question from Daniela was about how influence can, why not use the influence on the YouTube channel? Of course, YouTube is a pretty fundamental resource. I just wanted to share what tool I'm using. It's really as simplistic as that. Whereas I do understand that people do want to sort of point people towards an application. I think it's important to find the one that's best for you. That's why I share the lessons part of it more, because that's the most important part, the ones that I guess you can apply to any situation. So just to wrap things up, again, I'll be doing that video very soon about how I use every tool. We'll still be covering the great tools in the productivity space. I wanted to say a big thank you to everyone because obviously this video came as a bit of a shock. What a way to end 2020, right? Just me doing a I'm leaving Notion video. I feel like it was a bit savage timing. But Notion actually put a really nice comment on Twitter about like, it's not the end sort of thing. I really respect that and really love the fact that so many people use Notion around the world to get things done. In much the same way as people use Trello, Todoist, Asana, TickTick, and the millions more apps out there. The next couple of weeks will be interesting because we're going to share something called Keep Focused, which is a little side project that will address productivity advice and tips more than apps, which I think is something we haven't addressed as much on this channel before. It's really about the methods over the tools, and hopefully we can pay more attention to that in the next year. Folks, I just want to say a big thank you. I love sparking conversation as well about the role of tools and things like that, and the administration of productivity, which over the next couple of weeks we'll address. But a big thank you, and I really hope you have a fantastic new year. Anyway, folks, cheerio.